remember all of the times we spent together. A way to get by my guilty pleasure. And I couldn't find anyone better, anyone like you. Cause I remember the day that you left me in December. Snow on the ground as a reminder that I couldn't find anyone better, anyone like you. And I bet I'm just fine without you, without you.
Welcome to the 14th annual Friends of Max Kolb Telethon. I'm your host, Neha Joy.
And I'm John Yospel, your hype man for the evening, also known by my street name as DJ Jazzy John, Mother of Dragons, for all the homies watching tonight.
John, we talked about this. What are you doing?
Neha, you fool! The telethon is going urban this year. I'm just trying to connect to the people. And I'm pretty sure I sent you a list of street names to use for the show.
Yeah, I'm not going to be called Neha Nizzy Joy or Nehey on live television.
Not even DJ Joy to the world?
Definitely not DJ Joy to the world.
But I worked so hard on that one.
We're here to celebrate our hardworking and passionate film students, not be rap gods.
I understand.
No, you don't.
No, I don't.
Tonight is dedicated to raising money for the Max Kolb Scholarship while also entertaining you with a variety of performances and segments.
Max Kolb was a Hofstra film student who tragically passed away in 2001. For the past 14 years, the Max Kolb Scholarship has been awarded to deserving film students in his honor.
Max was a caring and motivated film student, and this annual telethon allows us to raise money for students just like Max. Over the years, we've raised more than $50,000 to help offset the production costs for these eager student filmmakers.
As a thank you for all of your generous donations, we have an array of gifts to give away tonight. Throughout the show, my main man and homeboy, our very own premiums correspondent, Michael Fuller, will be giving us updates on the giveaways available for donors. Phone lines are now open and operators are standing by. So to donate, call 516-463-1200 or donate online by going to our website, maxkolbtelethon.com.
Throughout the show, we'll be hearing from more of our student filmmakers and some Hofstra Film alumni as they discuss the difficult process of making their films, why they enjoy filmmaking, and how the Hofstra Film Program has helped them become successful.
Right now, let's hear from some current Hofstra filmmakers and find out their favorite aspect of the filmmaking process.
I was inspired to be a filmmaker because I like movies and I like the creation of an idea from the initial thought to the execution, and I just really love seeing visions come to life. I personally like the whole writing side of filmmaking. I like that an idea can start on the page or in your mind and ends up being physically manifested at the end of the day or at the end of the month or the end of the year when you finally, you know, get that little portion done.
A lot of movies that I've watched, a lot of my favorite movies, Undercover Brother, Scott Pilgrim, they do various different things and they have great themes to them. It's always been my goal with film to have that conversation when it comes to important topics in society. And I think all great films have great themes that touch upon a different perspective of society and how it could possibly change or differ from another person's perspective.
Film gives you the ability to cry, to love, to be happy, to be sad, and you know, you can't get into anybody else's shoes unless you're watching a film about being in someone else's shoes.
Getting other people around you to point out stuff that you don't see or never really thought of before, that helps to really make your film, you know, really worthwhile.
My favorite part of the filmmaking process is definitely the post-production. I love directing and I love being able to direct films, but for me, getting into post-production, it's a joy to edit the film and make it into the film that everyone gets to watch.
Editing, you are like, you have all the stuff, and then you're able to just sit and you don't have to deal with anyone else, and you have your stuff in front of you, and you just make it, and you can try a whole bunch of stuff, and no one needs to know whether it looks like crap or not, and you can just do it for hours.
Now we're here with our premiums correspondent, Michael Fuller, who'll be showing us some of the great items we have available for our donors.
Thanks, Neha, and congratulations, because we're starting the night with $732. So remember to donate. You can call 516-463-1200 or go to maxkolbtelethon.com. Now, when you donate, you get the chance to choose from a variety of premiums in different price categories. And these are just a few of the items you can bid for tonight. Now, imagine if you could be sitting at a stadium, sunglasses on, and enjoying some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. Well, now you're in luck, because up for grabs tonight, we have some Mets tickets. And you can also root for your home team in style with one of our Mets bundles. We have just about everything you're gonna need to show your Mets spirit, no matter what the weather is. Now, for my Yankees fans, we have some fantastic tickets up for grabs as well, so definitely don't miss out on that. And all the Game of Thrones fans out there should listen up, because we have everything you would ever want and need. I'm talking from t-shirts, hats, and collectible items to seasons 1, 2, and get this, 3 on DVD. So check out the variety of TV show gear we've got for you tonight. We're sure to have something for fans old and new. And for the cherry on top, we have restaurant gift cards for that perfect night out. Or if staying in is more your speed, we have a great Rachel Ray cookware set and cookbook so you can make some yummy treats at home. Now, these are just some of the items you can claim tonight. So be sure to check out our website for a complete list of premiums that you can bid on.
All amazing prizes. And while our phones are ringing, let's bring out another musical performance. Here's Van Vega.
Thank you. the water is a place to be alone. She can't wrap her head around it, let alone her lips. But backing down is better than she knows. And everybody's hurt. She got a complex, big condition. Never touched, never taken out of her box. Made aware of her own volition. That means there's no turning back. How much more alive on the town? How much more flash in the sky? How much to feel an addiction? To the night, to the night, to the night. She got a complex, mid condition. Never took, never taken out. To the night, to the night.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the 8th annual,
12th annual, 13th annual Friends of Max Kolb Telethon.
The Max Kolb Telethon is definitely a really amazing way to honor a past student who unfortunately passed away and left us.
The Max Kolb Telethon means so much to me. I would say that it's an opportunity for filmmakers to truly be given the funds to spur their dream and further fund it, because as a film major, it costs a lot of money. Filmmaking isn't cheap, and so I think every film major does it for the passion, and to find a scholarship or a grant that's willing to help you take your dream to from thought to reality is a true blessing.
I think the Max Kolb Telethon is a bit of a saving grace for film student expenses. Especially when I first came here, I started to realize that a lot of the stuff that we have to do in order to get our films off the ground and make them really worthwhile is financing.
If you're giving somebody a scholarship for a project, it really keeps them going, knowing that people want to see more of what you're doing. And I think that as long as we have that, that's all we do it for. I mean, there will be no reward in filmmaking if people didn't want to see more. You know, you shoot something and you put your blood, sweat, and tears in it, and then if people say they want to see more from you and give you something to make that happen, then I think that's the best reward you can honestly ask for.
The Max Kolb Telethon is a great way for students to pursue their dream of filmmaking, and it's a wonderful way to carry on Max's dream as a filmmaker and remember who he was and what he was passionate about.
The Max Kolb Telethon actually allows young filmmakers the chance to tell their stories and to do what they really want to do and what they've dreamed of.
What the Max Kolb Telethon shows is that the community of this department is the strongest ever. People support other people's endeavors. They're always there to help out, and because of that, you know, we have something great like this where people can contribute to each other and help make other people's dreams come alive.
The 2014 Friends of Max Kolb Scholarship winners are Michael Cacchetti. We have Desmond Jackson.
Desmond Jackson!
I'm eternally grateful for the Max Kolb Scholarship. It's helped me in terms of, in my 47, I was doing a very big production and I needed some more extra funds. And when I received the Max Kolb Scholarship, it helped me immensely. And I will ever thank them, because that film was a learning lesson within itself.
I think the one thing I got from getting the telethon and getting part of the film grant was that I guess I've kind of cemented myself here somehow with the work I was doing. And that was more gratifying than getting the money. Being able to know that I'm recognized for something that I've been working towards, that speaks louder than any amount of cash that could have been donated to me for my film.
The scholarship is an opportunity, it's a blessing, and it's a true reward for those who have definitely worked for it.
Now,
Man, those Van Vega dudes totally kick some ass.
Watch it, John.
What? I was gonna say astronomically funky jams. They kick some astronomically funky jams.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say kick some ass.
Watch it, Neha. You nasty.
Well, we are still going strong here in Studio A with a lot of performances coming your way.
Up next, we have local Long Island indie alternative band, Kodiak. Ladies and gentlemen, please raise the roof.
Give it up for Kodiak.
When you're gonna feel so lost, when you're here feel alone, can we talk about your trip? Some of those boys just make me sick. Your time, but tell me hurry it up. Let's move across the hall. Breaking ways we worked before. Oh, 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 oh. Fall asleep, fall on the floor.
Everybody, Now we're gonna check in real quick with everybody's favorite Premiums correspondent and member of the DJ Jazzy Boys posse, Michael Fuller.
Who are you?
I'm just trying to keep it urban, Neha.
Michael, what do we have going on over there? We hear we have some great new premiums.
That's right, Nizzy, and I got you, John. We making it rain over there with those premiums. Well, we have raised $1,500, and we're gonna keep things rolling with a very special premium, 2 round-trip JetBlue tickets. I mean, who doesn't want a vacation? Now, I know you're looking to get away for a little R&R, or maybe you're a student who needs to fly home. Well, this is the perfect gift for you. But don't wait, because these won't last long. Now, we still have plenty of items for you guys tonight, so check out our website, and don't miss your opportunity to claim these great gifts. And to donate, you can call now and talk to one of our operators at 516-463-1200 or go online at maxcopetelethon.com. Now, throughout our show, we'll be showing you clips from some of the senior films created this year. Let's check it out.
I'm in the Cuba Mountains right now. I'm in a natural lagoon. It's about 20 to 25 feet. Now I'm gonna jump in. If I die, tell my mom I love her very much.
Now I bet you're wondering, what the hell was that guy mumbling about? Well, that mumbler is me, Evan Crochet. I'm a Cuban-American seeing a place which few of us have been allowed to see, the beautiful island of Cuba. Very little has changed in our relationship with the Caribbean nation since we cut ties almost 60 years ago. But we definitely can't say that anymore, as it's all about to change forever.
I'm not wearing these anymore. I'm pissed. I'll tell you one last time. This is a horrible idea. Stop trying to harness your inner shark.
I gotta get pumped up, man.
How do I look?
Desperate.
Yeah.
Kevin, what are you doing
hey,
here?
Babe.
Kevin, what are you doing?
Giving my girlfriend a hug and a kiss.
Girlfriend, Kevin, we broke up.
You were serious about that?
Yes, and that was 2 months ago. Plus, I'm dating Jeff now.
What does he have that I don't have?
Money, a job. Plus, he bought me a Louis Vuitton bag. You know, something you could never do.
Okay, but I love you. Isn't that enough?
No.
Come on, let's go get some burritos, some chips and guac.
Oh, Kevin, ew, burritos? Really? Okay, Jeff takes me to nice steakhouse dinners at restaurants, okay? Actual restaurants, not Burrito Town or wherever you go, okay? That's not good enough for me.
Okay.
Goodbye, Kevin. How's your audit coming?
Jeez, Michelle, it's coming. It's...
Meeting's in 10.
Wait, really?
Yes, really. Some big announcement, I think.
Hey, did you guys get new TVs at your desk? Great, management's trying to butter us up again.
I don't know.
I'll see you in 10.
All right, we're just hitting you guys with one band after another. Up next, we have
Neha. What's going on?
Oh, I'm just introducing the next band. John, what are you doing here?
I thought we were gonna go memorize that Biggie verse together. You totally promised me that we're gonna perform it later on in the show.
Oh, right, yeah, I'll meet you there. I will meet you there.
It was all a dream, I gotta memorize the rest.
Well, up next, we have an up-and-coming indie electronica band with a very special acoustic performance for you guys. Give it up for Phases. Thank you.
again, girl, you're running through my head. There you go again, rummaging through my bed. You collect your things when we're way too young for these kind of rings, hey, hey. But if I knew this would be my last day, I'd spend it with you. You're everything I do, and if it all came true, you're everything I want. Everything I want. There you go again, girl, you're running through my brain. There you go again, yeah, you're playing your old games. To dry on a rainy day, she came back wet and she was ready to play. Guess I'm a lucky man who doesn't know when to quit. I'm a lucky dude, knows that he must choose if he will win or everything he wants. You can lead him to the water, but you can't make him drink. And you can spend your life together, but the words come out in many shades. It's not clearly black and white, it's not clearly wrong or right. Cause after all, I'm a lucky man who doesn't know when to quit. Everything he wants. Everything he wants.
What keeps me going when these long shoot days and the lack of sleep, poor food, like poor health, and you get sick all the time, I keep going because when I watch a film and I see how amazing it is, I say that I want to be a part of, and I want to be the person that made it.
In my first 2 years at Hofstra, I was gripping and PAing, and I was very, very eager to learn, so I was always enjoying anything that came at me. The long hours are part of the job. Producing a film, you get to really come in close contact with the directors, and so I've had several moments where I've had what I like to call real talks, where we kind of just lay everything out there. I say my spiel, they say what they feel about what I have to say, what they're going through, and it's building that relationship.
When big problems occur on set, and when the stress level just gets way too high, and you start kind of either doubting what you're doing completely, or doubt how the project's going to turn out in general, the one thing that kind of gets you grounded is being able to surround yourself with people who not only work well with you, but get your personality and are really close friends with you. the relationships that you have with people, that's what makes the films. That's what makes the production stuff worth going through and being stressed out about, you know, for weeks at a time. Because if you go on set with people that know what they're doing, but you can't personally be on a good level with them, it's not over, but it's pretty close to being dead in the water.
Finding a team that is willing to put in the effort and who shares your dream of whether you're the writer or director of the screenplay is definitely important, and it's difficult. You have to find people who are willing to put in the hours before they hit the shower.
Usually at the end of the day, even when things were stressful, even when you thought you upset someone or the people don't like you or weren't happy with your work, someone will come up to you and say, hey, no big deal, good job, okay, and then you go home and you do it the next day and same thing, things go wrong and people get over it.
In the production, the hardest aspect is easily the time management, because you have a schedule which, as hard as you hold to it, will always have problems and you'll always have to adjust as you go. And it makes it kind of difficult to hold true to an 8 to 10 hour day. I've been on shoots that sometimes occasionally go 14 to 18 hours, and it just sometimes it happens because you have to keep going, you have to get everything done, or you have to start sacrificing things.
On a set, you know, keeping continuity is something that seems so simple, but it's pretty hard to do because you're shooting day one on Friday, and then you're shooting day one again, but on Monday. So you have to remember what they wore, how bloody their shirt was, and sometimes you forget when you have so many other things on your mind.
What keeps me going as a filmmaker is just knowing that eventually I will have a final product, because I have to keep going. Like, if I give up, then I know I'll never have it and it'll never be finished. But if I keep going, then it will be, and that's like the best reward, to know that you finished something.
Right before I started shooting my senior film, like, I was like, I couldn't sleep for days. I was like, you know, just stressed out. And as soon as I got on set and you're working with people that you know are gonna come through for you, and you see them start setting up frame and then you see frame, that's when it all just kind of, all the stress kind of just disappears and you're just kind of in the zone. Anything else in the world could be happening, and there's nothing else I'm thinking about besides my film.
Filmmaking is tough and it's very stressful, but I think it's all worth it, because when you have a finished product and you have something that you're working for, you know, the passion and the stress and the tears, you know, they all make sense. It all makes, you know, perfect sense where you have a finished product you can be proud of. And it makes it worth it that you made something. When someone watches a movie, they don't think about every single detail that goes into that. They don't realize that, you know, they got, you know, 20 people that are involved, you know, writers, tons of money, tons of different, you know, factors involved into just making one shot. Everyone thinks you just point a camera at like a subject and you got a film. And there's just so much more than that, and it really is, you know, nerve-wracking when you're, you know, working on one and you can, in your head, like me personally, I get really caught up in all the details and it freaks me out and I have like maybe a possible nervous breakdown. But at the end of the day, you look at it and you're like, this is a good, you know, moment, you know, captured on film.
Novi, initiate emergency protocol.
Error. Core misaligned. Error. Error. Power cell overload. Critical cell. Core systems functional. Critical damage sustained. Machine integrity 14%.
Dylan, would you like to answer the question?
I
been having thoughts about Erica.
What kind of thoughts?
Love. I love Nicole, but I also still love Erica.
It's normal, Dylan, to still have feelings for Erica. You loved it deeply, and had it not been for the accident, it's likely the two of you would still be together.
I miss feeling that kindness and compassion.
I'm loving those senior films, and to think that's only a glimpse of what the seniors have been working on all year. Well, that's what tonight's donations are all about. So remember to keep calling in and checking online before these premiums are gone. Well, thank you for your ongoing support and staying with us tonight. There's still a lot more left in the show, so let's take a look at some more of our featured premiums. Well, as their diehard fans already know, the New York Islanders have been having one of their best seasons yet. So why not commemorate their last games at the Nassau Coliseum with an Islanders hockey stick that has been signed by the entire 2014-2015 team. Pretty cool, right? Well, another special premium we have is from the Children's Place. This is a great clothing accessory store for all the little ones in your life. Here we have a $500 gift card that you can use to buy the cutest outfits for any occasion. So that's all we have for you at the moment. We'll keep you all up to date on what we have left later on in the show. But for right now, let's see how Hofstra's film students answer this very interesting question.
If I had to have any celebrity play me in a movie, if I wanted, the one that I want would be like someone like Colin Farrell in a Martin McDonagh movie, because Martin McDonagh can write characters like no one else can. But realistically, I would probably be John Cusack. If people say I look like him, say anything for some reason.
If I could have any celebrity play me in a movie adaptation about my life, it would be Christopher Walken, because he's Christopher Walken.
Kanye West. Kanye West is not the best actor, but I love Kanye. He's been like a celebrity role model in terms of always challenging the status quo, always making a unique product. I would love for Kanye West to play me in a film. He's a rebel, and I consider myself a rebel in certain aspects, so he always challenges the status quo, and I definitely want him to portray me in a film if he ever got the chance.
If I could play any celebrity in any movie, it would be Uma Thurman in Kill Bill, so I would have her play me.
If I could have a celebrity play me, it would have to be Josh Peck. Everyone tells me I look like him, and it's really nice. Just watch Red Dawn, look at Josh Peck, and you'll see the resemblance.
If I had to pick one, honestly, that I think would be a good representation of who I might be, I guess it might be Joaquin Phoenix. He has a very interesting range, where he can be very calm and collected and have a very, very relaxed demeanor about it, but then he can also be insane.
Up next, we have a very talented comedian taking the stage and one of Hofstra's own, Manon Brozoszewski.
That's right, Neha. A personal favorite of mine, Manon has been performing stand-up since her freshman year and hopes to make people forget about their problems by listening to hers.
So let's take a listen. Here now is Manon Brozoszewski.
Hey, guys. I'm from Philadelphia. And over the weekend, my cousin sent me into the hood to buy some stolen watches for him. I don't know why he chose me to do it, probably because of my tough exterior. But I went to the corner where he described, and there was this guy in like this huge jacket standing there. And I was like, it looked like it was filled with something. And I was like, oh, it must be filled with watches. So I kind of went up to him, and I was trying to play it cool. And I was like, hey, what's up? And he was like, what are you looking to buy? And I was like, I don't know, I'm looking to try to get some watches. And he was like, I don't have any watches, but you need some one of them? I said, what? He said, you need some pumpkin pie? Opens his coat and the entire thing is lined with pumpkin pies. And I said, no, I don't need any pumpkin pies, I'm good. But when the guy with the watches comes back, just let me know. So I went away, and when I came back, I saw the guy with the watches, and he was like the scariest looking thug you have ever seen in your life. And I looked at him, and he looked at me in my eyes and said, "What do you need?" And I said, I heard there was a guy selling pumpkin pies. I've become very emotional lately. I don't know where it's coming from. I think it stems back to when I was like 12 years old, and I had like an emotional connection to inanimate objects. Like my best friend was an almond. His name was Bob the Almond. And we used to dress him up in like little outfits, and I'd make him like, I'd take him places and show him things, and I made him like a little paper house, and we had an almond family for him. And my biggest regret was that when I left for summer break, I left him in the home that I'd made for him. And I said my goodbyes, and that was my biggest regret, because when I came back to school, he was gone, and I'll never forget that little nut. Just last week, I saw someone eating a bag of trail mix, and I had to leave the room. Spring break just passed, and during spring break, we had a family party. And my cousin brought her new boyfriend to the family party, and he was like a huge redneck. Like when that comedian asks every time if he does this, he might be a redneck, he always said yes. He was telling me and my grandmother this story, and he was like, "I was out, me and my boys were out shooting coons, we're out getting the rabbits, we were catching them, skinning them, cutting them up, you know what I mean? And then my one friend had a soda bottle he put on their truck. He put the soda bottle on the truck. And, you know, I was like, what are you doing? He was like, you know what I mean? And I said, no. Nobody knows what you mean. And then later, we had, like, this cheese board. And I was watching him. This is true. I saw him pick up an entire wheel of brie cheese and just bite into it like it was a sandwich. And he was like, that's good. This is good. And he just kept eating it, the whole thing. And everyone's just watching him. My family parties are really weird. Like, we have a lot of strange people in our family. Like, my one aunt, she's always drunk, but she swears she can see dead people. Whereas I think she's really looking at regular people but can't tell the difference. And she says that, like, late at night, this older woman, like, comes in and sits by her bed and just stares at her while she's sleeping and just watches her like right in her face. And to me, that sounds like a personal problem. Being in Philadelphia reminds me that I used to work in a barbecue restaurant. Worked in a barbecue restaurant for like 4 years. And it was down the street from the prisons. So when the prisoners got out of jail, they came to the restaurant to use the telephone to call their friends to come pick them up. And this one guy came in, and he was like 300 pounds, and his name was Petey, and he was missing two fingers, and he had no tongue. How do I know? He showed me. And said he said he needed something squishy to eat because his mouth hurt, and that's when I started to get really overheated. And he asked to use the telephone, and I was in no position to refuse him the telephone, so I gave it to him. And then I went and took somebody else's order. And I'm taking this guy's order, and when it finishes, I look back to him, and he just looks at me and says, "No answer," like it was my fault. And then I started to get really scared. So I gave him like a free cup of creamed spinach for him to just like slosh around in his mouth. I don't know. And then, but the worst part, the scariest part was when he was leaving the restaurant, he turned around and winked at me and said, "I'll see you later, sweet meat." And I still get chills thinking about it. And thank you so much, guys. Have a good night.
Excellent job, man, and very funny stuff. I especially love the joke about the wacky, unexpected situation.
We're gonna kick it over to Michael Fuller for an update on our premium giveaways. But first, let's check out some more clips from our senior films. Take a look.
Hi. I just moved here. Not sure if you'd heard. I'm Olivia. What's your name?
Henry Green.
Nice to meet you. I moved about a block away from here, exploring the new neighborhood. Here with my dad.
Okay.
It's a nice place. It's especially nice that there's a bus route.
Okay. Okay.
I'm sorry, I tend to ramble. Don't really have a filter. Just keep rambling on.
Okay.
Nice model.
Thanks.
I prefer buses. Trains just make me uneasy.
I prefer trains.
Oh.
They stay on rails, and they can't go anywhere else. Have a nice day.
What is he doing here? I thought I told you not to come around here anymore. I don't want to see your miserable, disgusting face around here.
Never!
What are you doing?
I told him not to come here.
What? Relax, Jude, relax. He didn't mean any harm, all right? Here, look. Why don't you just take this money?
You shouldn't encourage him.
Look at this. Nothing wrong with giving those less fortunate than us, right?
If you say so. The church and the town bar are this way. If you like, we'll show them to you now.
Mom was right. Can't manage on my own.
You give her way too much credit. When she was at the end, she always used to sit on the couch and wait for you to come home. Neither of us have very good timing, do we? Come on. We've got a long day tomorrow.
Welcome back, everyone, to the 14th annual Max Kolb Telethon. You know, over the past 14 years, a community has been created to help keep Max Kolb's memory alive and to help the dreams of Hofstra filmmakers come to life. We wanted to take some time to give some special shout-outs for their contributions tonight and over the years. Well, a huge thank you to the founder of the Max Kolb Telethon, Laura Fu, for her continued support and for fostering not just a show, but an opportunity to give back within the School of Communication. An important aspect of our efforts is the continued support provided by our alumni. This past Thursday, April 23rd, Hofstoria, a Western Queens networking event, was organized by the Herbert School's Alumni Association. This event raised over $600 towards the Max Kolb Scholarship. We would like to thank the Alumni Association, Dean Adria Marlowe, alumni Jamie Cohen, and Nikki Sammartino for organizing this incredible event, along with the following businesses who donated door prizes: Astoria Beer and Cheese, Queen's Kickshaw, Donut Plant, Oliver's Pub, Single Cut Brewery, The Brass Owl Shop, Raven's Head Public House, Coffeed LIC, Socrates Sculpture Park, and Astoria Coffee. Thank you for your support. Back to you, Neha and John.
Up next, we have local Long Island indie alternative band Kodiak. Be sure to check out their self-titled album released earlier this year on their Bandcamp page and to like them on Facebook to see their latest updates.
Let's hear it once again for Kodiak.
Because we have more great performances lined up for you later in the show. But for right now, let's hear once again from our senior filmmakers.
Hofstra's film program has really helped me by giving me a lot of depth to my filmmaking abilities. I've been able to take lots of classes that specialize in like cinematography, directing, and I've been able to really see what each individual position does.
Coming into Hofstra, I almost knew absolutely nothing about filmmaking. I did a film club at my high school. I started that. And then coming here, I was just like a newborn babe.
Hofstra's film program has really helped me progress in the way that it allows us students to just get our hands in and get dirty and to actually write the script, produce it, film it, and edit it all ourselves.
I think what's great about the Hofstra Film School is that each professor is very informal, and it seems like kind of like a subtle thing. When you're doing creative stuff, it's such an internal thing that if you're teaching something like that on a formal basis, you're not able to connect. My favorite thing about the film department is definitely that they really want students to explore their own creativity, and they don't want to limit you in any way or censor you. They want you to be yourself and show your art to the world.
Hofstra's film program is a very unique one because it's equal parts hands-on and guided, and you can learn from multiple different people and each other. And as long as you start making films with this program, you know, you never really stop.
Having the community here is, I can't stress this enough, really important, because I'm sure people know this, but when you go to make a film and you suddenly realize you need a crew and you need this happen, to be able to say, hey, I need help, and someone say, yeah, sure, I'll help you, it's just it's a great feeling, and it's just like, it's one less thing to worry about.
You should definitely learn to collaborate with people, because you'll come across certain students that are more perverse in a certain field say like art direction or certain methods of storytelling that you don't know. And being able to share that knowledge all together is helpful in all parts.
Teamwork definitely makes the dream work, and I think that's been proven more here from my time at Hofstra than has before in any of my high school curriculum and anything I've done outside of Hofstra.
Everyone is really into working with each other to make the same, like to make their own work. You know, other film programs are very cutthroat, but Hofstra's is very geared towards collaboration and making other people's dreams come alive.
Zero. Sound.
Five,
ready to dissolve.
Four,
three,
two,
and dissolve
one.
Three.
Gentlemen, we are back. We're still trucking along here in Studio A with tons of great premiums for you tonight. And so far, we have raised over $2,000. But if you, there we go, that's it, it's good. But if you missed out on something that your heart was set on, don't worry. We've got a couple of items here that will make you forget all about the ones that got away. Now, I know we've got some college students out there watching, and after all, we are on a college campus, so this bundle from Comedy Central should be right up everybody's alley. We have merch from Key & Peele, and Workaholics, we've got shirts, sweatshirts, and a whole bunch of other goodies, so grab that while you can. And for any kid, or for the kid at heart, we have Sesame Street merchandise to keep you having fun for days. I'm talking books, DVDs, and toys galore of your favorite Sesame Street characters, including Elmo, Cookie Monster, and all of their other fun-loving Muppets on the street. Now make sure to keep those phones ringing. Well, that's all for me for now. Let's check back in with John and Neha to see what we have coming up next.
Thanks for the update, Michael. Well, we've seen many scholarship recipients over the past 10 years get a jump start on their careers from this very telethon. But what does the scholarship allow them to accomplish? Where do they end up?
Richie Filippi won the Max Kolb Scholarship as a sophomore in 2003 and took on the task of producing the annual Max Kolb Telethon himself during his last semester as a TV film student.
Richie caught up with us all the way from Los Angeles about how the scholarship ultimately gave him the confidence to accomplish his dreams and even work with Hofstra alumni to make The Eve, a soon-to-be-released horror film.
Stay tuned for the premiere of The Eve trailer after we look at what this Herbert School alum is doing now.
Hi, I am Richie Filippi, class of 2005. I was a Bachelor of Science in TV, video, and film, and currently I'm a production manager and producer. Back in 2003, I didn't even know that the scholarship existed, and then one day there was a pat on my back and I turned around and I was, you know, handed a letter that sort of explained that I was one of the first recipients of the scholarship. It came out of nowhere. It was such an honor. There was a lot of times before I got the scholarship that I wondered if I would be able to stay in the major I was in. And getting the scholarship gave me the confidence to not only stay on track, but I give it a lot of credit that gave me the confidence to move to LA, to really pursue my dreams, to not settle for the reality shows I was working right when I got on here, to really just keep on going and try to work on films and then eventually direct my own film. Ever since I was little, I've been fascinated with the horror and thriller genre. There's so much you can do with suspense and what you can't see. It's always been a playground that I've loved. And when I got the opportunity to make what was pitched to me as a Hitchcockian thriller, I was down from the get-go. The Eve was sort of like a mini Hofstra reunion. A low-budget movie shot on location in winter, in the middle of nowhere. These movies are so extremely difficult to produce. Angel Acevedo did a remarkable job producing the movie. Me and Angel went to Hofstra together. We were part of HFC, the Hofstra Filmmakers Club. So Brian Harnick was our director of photography. We had that trust from going to school together where I would storyboard, he would set the shot, and half the time I wouldn't look at it because I knew it was the shot I needed. We only had, you know, initially 13 days to shoot the whole movie, and if we didn't have that sort of trust, it would have never got done. The post-production on Eve was very, very tricky. Jess King, my wife, who I met at Hofstra while learning to load film, cut the movies. We had gone through two editors before she joined the project. She did such a fantastic job. On set, we had two current Hofstra students back when we shot it. They were a wonderful help, and it just showed the work ethic of Hofstra students to jump on this project for 15 days. It just made all the difference.
Dude, we should pull the beard.
Oh, man.
Yes, it's New Year.
Tomorrow,
we can wash away our sins to a clean slate.
Hey, you have neighbors?
Sort of. Nobody's there. But there may be one or two locals. Other than that, we're all alone.
We met at a continuing professional development for teachers networking night.
I mean, it's nothing as romantic as how you guys met.
He did get me this.
A toast to a different kind of New Year's. It may be cold, but it's good to get away from the stresses of life.
You're here.
You're here.
There's something in the house. What's wrong?
There's no freaking dial tone!
We'll fix it!
How the hell do you fix the phone?
No, no.
The main battery fuse is gone.
Well, where'd it go? We drove all the way down here. Where is it?
Someone took it.
Well, we have to lock the rest of these doors and check all the rooms.
Maybe there's somebody outside waiting for us to slip up and then kill us off one by one. Maybe there's a whole bunch of them. I don't know!
No, we're not gonna die, okay? Get inside of the house.
What are you doing up here?
We stay here till the sun comes up, and we make a run for it. Together.
We just saw an example of what one of our alums has been up to. Now let's take a look at some more work from our current senior filmmakers.
I'm here at the headquarters of the Funk Force, whose leader, Revolutionary Martin Alkins, was just murdered. Here's one of our heroes now, Janine.
Janine, what are your thoughts on the death of your leader?
Do you think you'd be a good superhero?
Is this an example of black-on-black violence?
Should a black woman be a superhero?
Can you comment on the drugs police found at the scene of the murder?
Do you feel inadequate being the only female member of this team?
Does Martin's death signify the end of the Black Lives Matter movement? You saw it here first, folks. Janine just tried to murder me. Up next, new sensation Alda Bucks is releasing a song just for ghetto kids entitled Crackhead Like Me. For more, stay with us here at Cox News. Back to you, Tom.
Can we really just go around us?
Yeah.
What are they doing?
Or not.
Oh my God, it's a gun? What the f***? Who locked the door?
What the f*** is that gonna do, Chris?
Get out of the car, motherfucker!
Get the f*** out of the car!
What the f*** is happening right now?
You
are dead. Get
the f*** out of
America!
Let's go!
Vamos!
Tucker! Are you
shot? Tucker!
What the f*** is this?
Oh,
Jesus Christ!
Hey, it's gotten into you two.
Banshee, how much longer are we gonna do this?
What do you mean?
We were just thinking that... Remember when we were kids and we used to say that... Haven't you ever wanted something better than this? Like, we go out and we steal stuff. And then we sell it and make pocket change. And repeat.
So you want to pull off bigger jobs?
No! No. Banshee, I mean like, leave. Start over somewhere. make something of ourselves, you know? Live better lives.
Better? We have everything we need right here. You tell me.
No,
you tell me. What would be better than what we already have right here? Where would you even go?
I don't know, anywhere. We could go anywhere we want. California, or up north.
Hawaii.
Hawaii.
Oh, yeah, Hawaii. With what money? We have a good thing going. We're fine.
All right, everyone, we're back here at our premiums table, but we have a very special guest with us right now, our premiums producer, Hanna Kate. Hanna, what do we have left for our viewers?
Well, Michael, I'm glad you asked because we still have a ton of great items left to auction off. So I don't know how big of a Modern Family fan you are.
I love that show, Hanna.
Oh, well, that's fantastic because you, I'm sure, like many other people out there, wish they were a part of the Modern Family.
Absolutely.
So if you can't find a way to become a Pritchett or a Dumphy, you can grab some of our Modern Family swag, and I'm sure that'll be just as satisfying.
Here we go.
We have t-shirts, hats, and funny toys, and they'll all make you just as happy as Phil Dumphy does. And now if you want to get a head start on your school year, or the more likely case being you want to get your son or daughter a head start on the school year in the fall, we have this back-to-school bundle that is filled with everything you need to get an A. We have folders, laptop cases, notebooks. We even have some headphones to keep you energized and organized while prepping for class. And then for our diehard Miami Dolphin fans out there, we've got bracelets, foam footballs, keychains, and more. So you can show off your Dolphin pride at all times. And I think that's about it for me right now, Michael, so I will give the show back over to you.
Thanks, Hanna. I appreciate it. Well, we haven't heard from John or Neha in a while. Let's see what they're up to, guys.
Thanks, Michael. So, Neha,
you know that one song that I can't get out of my head?
The things I'd give to know what goes on in your head, John.
No, not that song. I'm talking about the one that goes dum, do, 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 do. You know, that one.
Oh, you mean Uptown Funk. Mark Ronson, Bruno Mars.
That's Uptown Funk? I could have sworn that Uptown Funk was some kind of disease.
Performing one last time tonight, here's to you with one silky smooth cover of Uptown Funk.
Michelle Pfeiffer, that white gold. This one for them hood girls, them good girls, fake masterpiece. Stylin', wildin', living it up in the city. Got Chuck's on with Saint Laurent. Gotta kiss myself, I'm so pretty. I'm too hot, hot damn. Call the police and a fireman. I'm too hot, hot damn. Make a dragon wanna retire, man. I'm too hot, hot damn. Yeah, say my name, you know who I am. I'm too hot, hot damn. And my band by that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to ya. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to ya. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to ya. Saturday night, we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch. 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 Hey, 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 oh. Stop, wait a minute. Fill my cup, put some liquor in it. Take a sip, sign a check. Julio, get the stretch. Ride to Harlem, Hollywood, Jackson, Mississippi. We show up, we're gonna show out. Smoother than a fresh jar of skippy. For the police and a fireman, I'm too hot, hot damn. Make a dragon wanna retire, man. I'm too hot, hot damn. Bitch, say my name, you know who I am. I'm too hot, hot damn. And the band bout that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you. Saturday night we just watch. Don't believe me, 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 just watch. Before we leave, let me tell y'all a little something. Uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. Said uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. Said uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. Come on, uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. Dance, jump on it. You sexy, then flown it. If you freak dead, then own it. Don't brag about it, come show me. Come on, dance, jump on it. You sexy. Them flown in, cause it's Saturday night, we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch, come on. Don't believe me, just watch. 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 Hey, hey.
As a producer, I have to focus on making sure that the script is ready to be filmed. So I work with the writer, the director.
Recently on David Carlone's shoot that I was a producer on, I worked with him on the script and improved it together because I just gave him feedback and notes, and I think that's definitely a key aspect in producing.
Well, when I produce films, it's about getting locations, being sure the schedule's correct, being sure the budget's correct. It's really, you've got to think about all the things that no one else would normally think of.
Talking with the director and making sure you fully understand their vision, helping acquire locations, helping acquire crew, organizing the casting sessions, organizing the actors in terms of transportation.
Budget is huge as a producer, so you talk with the executive producer, find out what the grand total budget is, and then break it down by each department.
Another, in terms of other production tasks, is being on set, making sure everything's run smoothly, making sure the director himself is prepared for being on set, making sure that the crew knows what they're doing, making sure that the director has a great team on hand that works with his style.
You kind of have to play the devil's advocate in some ways. You have to be the bad guy, but at the end of the day, it's really up to you to make sure that everything is there when production rolls around.
No one producer can do it alone. It always takes a good team of producers to make a quality film product because it's such a wide range of activities, and if you try to do it on yourself, all by yourself, like I learned from Roland's, you'll just end up wanting to pull out your hair.
So far, we have raised over $2,100.
$2,100,
that's it. That's it, that's it. And there's still time left for all of you guys at home to snag some of our awesome premiums. But before we get back into showing off some more of our swag, the Telethon would like to thank a couple of people who donated some of the items that you are bidding for this evening.
For our Mets tickets and merchandise, a huge thank you to James Benish, manager of venue services for the New York Mets, for his continued contributions over the years. A fantastic $500 donation from the Children's Place was up for grabs tonight, thanks to alum Brittany Boehm, who is a public relations and social media manager with the company.
From the Rachel Ray Show, we'd like to give a huge shout out to senior associate producer Mandy DeCamp for donating our lovely cookware set and cookbook. Also, a special thank you to alum Haley Kriegel from the Miami Dolphins for all of our Dolphins gear.
Absolutely. And last but certainly not least, JetBlue has provided us with round trip tickets to quite literally anywhere your heart's desires. And the Telethon team would like to thank Jonathan Weitz, manager of digital media at JetBlue Airways.
We thank each and every one of our alums, businesses, and students for all of their contributions so we can have great premiums for our donors. We really appreciate all of your help.
So that's where we're at so far. We've only got a short amount of time left in our show, so let's get all of those donations in. Now, I'm pretty sure we got a few bands left, though. John and Aha, who do we have coming up next?
Well, I heard we were actually getting Mariah Carey.
Well, I think that was last year, John.
Well, Mariah or no Mariah, up next, we have an NYC-based band that specializes in the field of folk and roll.
Hey, guys. What does Paul Simon do when he's on fire?
I have no idea.
Stop folk and roll.
The band is called Luna Rose, and they were also veterans of Studio A, performing on a recent episode of Thursday Night Live. They've got an EP coming out this summer, but right now they're here for you at home and online. Luna Rose.
City streets get me high in this series of first highs, and I don't wanna say goodnight just yet. Leather jackets fill the air, latched onto the kids, pretending not to care. Don't you care, don't you dare, don't you care. But you just lit my flame. I saw it ignite all the sparks in the haze. And I want you to know that I'll be at your next show. Oh, 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 oh. When you light your flame and it beacons to strangers with a story ahead. And you light your flame and it beacons, but you'll be the last thought in my head tonight when we ignite. Oh, tonight when we ignite with the flame. To keep high hopes calm in this land of free for all. Pay attention now, uh-oh. Cause you just lit my flame. I saw it ignite all the sparks in the haze. And I want you to know.
I present our first act, Pretty Penny Turner!
I'm just a lonely little girl with nothing here to see or do. Awaiting by the five and dime and walking you.
Anybody got a light? Kid, you're a lifesaver. You know, I've been doing this same damn song for the first 10 years. Now I can hardly carry the tune. Still waiting for my big break, though. God knows it's taken long enough.
For Pretty Penny Turner!
What's your name? What is your name?
It's not. No. Please.
I can give you a moment to make peace with your God. But after that, I gotta do it. You understand? Understand?
Yes.
The Iron Curtain has fallen!
It doesn't fall until I say
Камос!
Божьей воле.
Your generous donations tonight, we have raised over $2,600. $2,600.
Awesome.
Excellent. And it couldn't have been possible, so thanks to you, our talented filmmakers can continue to follow their passion and hone their craft. But don't forget, there's still more premiums left, so you can continue to donate online at maxcobtelethon.com.
Thanks, Michael. Before we announce our scholarship winners, we wanted to thank all of the people who helped put this show together.
There were so many people involved, from all of our premiums donors, the School of Communication faculty and administration, all of our performers tonight, and the students that have put in countless hours this year and over the past 14 years to support this show and our student filmmakers.
And of course, this could not have been done without our audience watching at home. We're happy to present the Max Kolb Scholarship to 5 deserving student filmmakers this year.
And the 2015 Friends of Max Kolb Scholarship winners are... Trick envelope.
So excited.
David Carlone, Joseph Dibble, Holly Fisher, Alexis Sanzone, and Ryan Sarno. Congratulations to all of our winners this evening. And thank you again.
Well, again, congratulations to all of our winners. We truly appreciate it. We're going to play you out, guys, with one last track from Van Vega. This one's called Dynamo and is sure to put you in a feel-good mood. Thank you for all watching, and congratulations once again to all of our winners. Good night, everybody. Here's Van Vega.
Electric is thunder love. We burn on rooftops. They look up to us so high above.
Halo.